Although Punta Cana attracts mainly those who like to relax on site, most tourists still want to see some interesting places while visiting the Dominican Republic in order to diversify their vacation. The resort area of Punta Cana itself has virtually no known attractions, mainly due to the short history of the place and its homogeneous landscape. However, there are many attractions located close to Punta Cana. In this article, we will tell you about the attractions of Punta Cana, which are located no more than 100 kilometers from this resort area. What to see in Punta Cana? Basically, you don't have to know what to see in the Dominican Republic in the Punta Cana area, since the excursions offered in the area allow you to see all the most interesting places. You are unlikely to want to get to any of these places on your own, since this is often more expensive than buying a tour. However, it would be a good idea to initially know what you can see in Punta Cana in order to better understand what excursions are worth purchasing while vacationing in this resort area. The most popular places located relatively close to Punta Cana are Sayana Island, Catalina Island, Altos de Chavun, Cap Cana, Fun Fun Cave, Manati Park, and Marinarium. We will tell you about all these attractions of Punta Cana below. Sayana Island. Sayana Island is one of those must-see places during your holiday in Punta Cana. This island has enviable natural beauty and its flora and fauna are protected. Sayana is part of the Eastern National Park. Sayana Island is located near the southeastern tip of the Dominican Republic, south of the province of La Altagracia, and is washed by the waters of the Caribbean Sea. An excursion to Sayana is one of the most popular among tourists who come on holiday to Punta Cana. It is the largest island in the entire Dominican Republic, with an area of about 110 square kilometers. Here all natural gifts are protected, so to this day Sayana is an untouched tropical paradise with pristine beaches, lush exotic vegetation and a variety of animals, including birds and reptiles. In order to get to Sayana Island, you must first come to the town of Bayahibe, from where boats and catamarans depart to the island. The trip to Sayana by catamaran lasts approximately 2 hours, but by speedboat you can get there much faster. Besides its beaches, Sayana Island is famous for its abundance of coral reefs and the sea creatures that live within them, such as starfish, sea turtles, and exotic fish. The island's population is small, only a few hundred people, who are mainly engaged in fishing and serving tourists. One of the attractions of Sayana Island is the largest natural pool in the world, located directly in the sea 400 meters from the shore. This area, where the depth is barely more than 1 meter, offers ideal conditions for snorkeling. This natural pool is the perfect place to see a variety of exotic sea creatures such as starfish, corals, tropical fish, shells, and snails. In the area of this island you can also see some exotic mammals such as the manatee. If you are interested in the most popular attractions in Punta Cana, then you should not miss the opportunity to visit Sayana Island, as it is by far the number one attraction in the Eastern Dominican Republic. Altos de Chavun. This is a small Mediterranean-style town built above the Chavun River in the province of La Romana. It is located almost 100 kilometers from the city of Santo Domingo and about the same distance from many resort hotels in Punta Cana. Altos de Chavun offers its visitors the unique atmosphere of an old Mediterranean town with cobbled stone streets and ancient houses. Despite its old appearance, Altos de Chavun was built in the 70s of the last century. There is an archaeological museum, an amphitheater, a design school, a beautiful cathedral, restaurants, bars, and shops. Although Altos de Chavun has an ancient appearance, its history, as we have already said, dates back to the 70s, namely 1976. The idea of building a Mediterranean-style town near the Chavun River came from businessman Charles Bloodhorn, president of the Gulf and Western Corporation. The town was designed and built by Italian architect Roberto Coppa, who hired hundreds of Dominican artisans to build a replica of the 16th-century Mediterranean village. The work continued for several years, and Coppa personally supervised every stage of the work. It can be said that Altos de Chavun is a work of art, as it is the result of the work of hundreds of craftsmen. Every stone used outdoors was cut and placed by hand by an artisan. Every detail of the building's wooden decorations and furniture is handmade by Dominican artisans. In 1982, construction of the town was completed. Altos de Chavín celebrated the opening with a Frank Sinatra concert in the amphitheater. The Church of St. Stanislaus is located in the center of the town. Because of its beauty and environment, it has become a place where thousands of couples have gotten married. Behind the Church of St. Stanislaus is an archaeological museum where you can see more than 3,000 examples of pre-Columbian artifacts. The Altos de Chavín Amphitheater is an architectural beauty of the Greek style. It can accommodate approximately 5,000 people during concerts and performances by famous artists. The Altos de Chavín School of Design has a multicultural approach to art and design and is affiliated with Parsons School of Design in New York and other major design schools. Although excursions to the Saona and Catalina Islands sometimes take tourists to Altos de Chavín, little time is usually allocated to explore all the beauties of this small town. So if you are very attracted to Altos de Chavín, then we advise you not to waste money and go here on your own. It is advisable to come here at lunchtime, when crowds of tourists are on the island of Saona, and Altos de Chavín has a calm atmosphere. In addition to the fact that you will be able to explore all the most interesting places of this town in a relaxed rhythm, you will also have the opportunity to relax in the atmospheric bars and restaurants of this place. Catalina Island. The natural attractions of Punta Cana are very popular among tourists, but Catalina Island attracts mainly not for its natural beauty, although this island is undoubtedly quite beautiful, but for the diving sites located near it. Catalina is a small island in the Caribbean Sea, a few kilometers off the coast of the Dominican Republic. Small because the island has an area of only 15 square kilometers, although it is the second largest in the Dominican Republic, after Saona. Like Saona, Catalina Island has beautiful beaches, pristine unspoiled beauty, white sand, and calm, clear waters. Catalina is an uninhabited island that is part of the Eastern National Park. Since the island is uninhabited, there is only infrastructure for receiving tourists. Catalina is visited mainly by diving enthusiasts, as well as tourists who are attracted by the unique natural beauty of this place. In addition, tourists visit this island during cruises. There are three main beaches on Catalina Island, which have fairly simple names, East, West, and North. Currently, the western beach is the most popular, while the other two beaches have huge potential for tourism development. Catalina Island is ideal for all types of water activities, but tourists mainly enjoy diving and snorkeling, as the waters around the island contain an impressive variety of marine life. Off the coast of this island you can see numerous colorful corals, exotic fish, starfish and other amazing representatives of underwater life. Like Saona Island, boats to Catalina leave from Bayahibe, but they go in the other direction. Some tour operators sometimes combine an excursion to Catalina Island with a visit to the town of Altos de Chavín. Fung Fung Cave. The Fung Fung Cave is one of the largest in the world and allows you to not only test your physical limits, but also be transported back in time. The adventure begins in the morning with a breakfast of fresh tropical fruits, snacks, and coffee. After breakfast, the instructor will make sure that everyone is ready to enter the cave, as you will have to travel about 2 kilometers underground. You will be given equipment in the form of a special suit, boots, a seat belt and a helmet, which not only protects you, but also has a flashlight. After entering the cave, you will have to descend 20 meters. When you go down, you will see many tunnels with stalactites and stalagmites inside the cave. After a challenging walk through the cave, you'll take a horseback ride to the ranch, where you can enjoy healthy food and drinks. Manatee Park. If you are interested in attractions in Punta Cana for children, then one of the best places is Manatee Park. This is a huge theme park dedicated to the fauna and flora of the Dominican Republic. This is more than just a zoo. Here you can experience the rich nature of the Dominican Republic and watch themed and animal shows. Inside Manatee Park, visitors can watch animal shows such as horse dancing, parrot pirouettes, dolphin jumping, sea lion shows, etc. It also offers shows to help you better understand the culture and folklore of the Dominican Republic. For example, a Taino Indian show is held here, during which you can see the beautiful ritual dances of the first inhabitants of this region. Another interesting and very popular activity in Manati Park is swimming with dolphins. Visitors here will be able to swim with dolphins in the pool under the supervision of trainers. In the park you can find various animals, such as iguanas, flamingos, exotic birds, snakes, sea lions, crabs. Marinarium. Marine enthusiasts should definitely visit the marinarium in Punta Cana, which offers the opportunity to swim with sharks and rays and see a wide variety of corals. You can choose when to travel, morning or afternoon. The Punta Cana Marinarium is a marine park and the animals that inhabit it are highly trained. In addition, specialists ensure a high level of security in the marine park, so there have not been any incidents in which animals attacked people. At the marinarium you can take a glass-bottom boat ride. In addition, the waiters will teach you how to prepare the Coco Loco cocktail from rum and coconut. But the entertainment doesn't stop there, as guests are also offered the opportunity to relax in the natural pools, sip cocktails prepared by the waiters, and listen to music.